Welcome back to Alien Isolation. I have adjusted the aspect ratio of the video slightly. We'll have to see if it looks better. It looks to me like the videos have been stretched for a little bit for a while now. Maybe it's a little late in the series to be making an adjustment to that to try to improve it, but we might as well try. And certainly it's something I want to think about. I'll want to keep in mind for potentially other VR titles if I run into similar issues. So finding a good adjustment for that is probably not a bad idea. Transit station to engineering. Wait. I'm in engineering. Right? This is engineering. Lorenz, Solomon's, SciMed, service. Offline. I assume we want to go to SciMed for San Cristobal. I'm just gonna go hide over here. Wow, if you would stop making so much fucking racket, that'd be great. Oh, it's a cement tower. I wonder if maybe we missed an update at some point. All right, so we're arriving. We have no listed objective currently. There might be some doors here we can open though now too. Yeah, let's start by going up to that locked one that way. You're seeing some synthetics.
Medical. Did you manage to get to comms?
I'm here, but I was too late. Apollo's recovered from the reactor purge and knocked out external comms again.
Damn it. So why'd you send me here?
Plan B, Rip. See, before I left, the system showed a ship approaching Sevastopol. I think it's the Inusadora. Marlow managed to send out his autocodes to call it in while comms were temporarily open.
We've got to get to it. Is it docking?
No. But it's in a holding position nearby. Head for the ambulance bay. The shuttle's a really short range, but they'll make it.
Got it.
Can we not? Can we not? do that? So, you want me to specifically go, yeah, through there. So that's basically where we were previously to just look for loots. There's also two transit control locked door over there. We could scope that out. Actually, yeah, let's get this, then go back and save, and then scout that out. Sorry, it's dusty in the space station. Hey, Mr. Xenomorph, kindly fuck off. Oh my god, we don't have the hacker thing yet. This was not a chop door, that's a hack door. Well, shit. I think we can probably assume we'll get it. We probably pick it up in this segment. And then we probably exit through there again. And then there's the door ready to go. Oh, there's a gap. Look at that. There's a gap in the texture. Chill out. Chill out. Chill out. Chill out. If we don't find anything, I'm not gonna save. Because the Xeno might show up. Because we take too long exploring. In which case, next time, we could just hoof it. Yeah, see, we picked up an actual ping on the tracker there. That's concerning. Too much clunking. Too much clunking in this fucking space station. That one's just locked. All right. Nothing has been achieved. I understand. Oh god, oh god, we're all gonna die. Can you imagine how much your fucking thighs would hurt creeping around like this all the time, this low to the ground? No? Nuh-uh. Door closed, door closed, door closed, door closed, door closed, door. Please close, please close your fucking self. Fuck. Fucking prick. Fuck you! I got out of there without wasting any ammo. Yeah. High five, team. We did it.
I see a launch on my terminal. Milo's already taken one of the shuttles.
Kind of hoping this is, like, kind of safe.
this.
Wait. There's a locked door directly behind me. Ambulance is that way. I'm just gonna go here for a moment. Wait, that's open too. Okay, we've been in there. There was an upper level. Apparently we've never been here.
Guard, my name is Julia Jones, and I'm a writer covering Sevastopol's decommissioning. I was hoping to interview you about your experiences on the station. You know, the limited medical resources, the mental effects on patients in deep space, that kind of thing. But look, Doctor, I've heard there was some kind of incident in the hospital recently. No one seems to know anything. Doctor, if there's a major public health issue here on Sevastopol, people...
Simon Tower Trans.
Need to know. I'm freelance. Unbiased. I don't have any corporate affiliation. Let me be a friend to you. Call me.
We've heard that before, I'm pretty sure. Is there a save point anywhere here? Not really. There's one down the hallway. But if we can cut through ER, we're not really going that way. I think we will, though. Got analysis room. Doesn't matter. right inside there. Shit.
Why not ask me about Sevastopol's safety protocols? Running causes accidents.
Wasn't counting on that.
This is a misunderstanding. You are making me waste company time.
Then fucking leave. Shit. Didn't need the second one. Ah, that door's fucking locked, bro. That door's fucking locked, bro. Why is that door locked? Shit, this is not the best position on account of wasted resources. Environmental control to primary care floor. Let's try to go up. Because there was gas on an upper floor somewhere. I'm not going to bother fucking healing. Not yet. We wasted so much Molotovs. Shit. I was a little panicked. Wait, what? Shit, that ladder is not actually here. It's up there. I think we dropped down here at one point. Shit. Okay. Well, in that case, what other options are there? Answer's not many. Dead end. Right under the fucking vent. Right under the fucking vent. Terrifying. Don't kill me, please. Ah, fuck it. He's not down. Where are we going? Straight down this hallway. That was bad. He came straight fucking at me. Good, I need a drink. Okay, ambulance bay. What are we doing here? What are we doing here? Thank you. Find an ambulance craft. Okay, okay. Fuck off. Go.
Damn, my Axis tuner isn't powerful enough.
No, no, sir. There has to be a way.
Where? Is it over there? There's a box. Stupidly close the fucking door behind you. You can still see the hallway back there. Because you're not supposed to see behind you. It's an illusion. Fun. Am I? Shuttle bay. Oh, this is the Anisadora. I honestly didn't remember that we actually go to the Anisadora. I had no fucking idea. Also, it's like the same building set as the space station, pretty much. I'm not sure if that's cutting some corners, which is okay. Or if there's some deliberate decision for it to be very similar in design. Because obviously, like, the Nostromo and the, what's the ship we came in on? I forget. Don't quite look like this. All right, we can stop creeping around. Especially now that we've saved. That That's got a fun xenomorph profile. With the pipe coming out. The pipes too. Yeah, that's really funny. The double pipes on the back. The ribs underneath made out of pipes too. I mean, this segment's different. This is a little bit like Gemini, but it's different. Yeah, now this feels more like I expected the ship to feel like.
We may have broken our losing streak. We've barely been scraping a living the past couple of years, and the Anisadora is starting to look like the wrecks we salvage. Can't say the crew's been faring any better. Then we found that flight recorder. It belongs to a ship, the Nostromo, Weyland-Yutani property. That means there'll be a reward. But then Marlow had an even better idea. Extrapolate the path of the flight recorder to try to find the wreck of the Nostromo. We got lucky. Found a distress signal, and now we're following it. This is it. I can feel it in my bones. He always said he'd do right by me.
I think he's the one. She's the one that dies. I think she was the original, the patient zero. We'll just rob him a little bit. I need this. Besides, why does he even have fuel? Signal detected. Heist says he just picked us kind of signal. Lose to Decode. Could be Nostromo. Nope. Aliens. Oops. No, I accidentally. I held flashlight button too long when I wanted to turn it off, and which is the shit, the reload. That was just a misclick. That was just a straight up misclick. Third time's a charm. We could read a computer message. Technicians report. Sublight engine work. It's falling off during the last jump. Okay, so here's something. It's never established in the alien films how the FTL travel works and if there's jumps. This says jump, but I've always thought it was more of like a warp bubble effect, like an Alcubierre drive. Just because it never felt like the ships were leaving and entering space, it felt like they were just, you know, traveling smoothly. I wonder.
We're outside Sevastopol. Marlow and Foster woke up first. She looked terrible. Meeks and me are about to take a shuttle to the station. But well, this has got to break quarantine procedures, right? It's Marlow's ship. She's Marlow's wife. And things got heated. And Meeks got a bloody nose. So, I don't know. Maybe the doctors will give her the all clear and things can get to normal. But if they sniff it out when we get on board, I don't want any part of it. Marlow doesn't pay nearly enough for that kind of noise.
Maybe the prequels establish a little bit more of a vibe with the ships, too, because you get to spend more time actually traveling on the ships, the Prometheus and the Covenant. Is the ship the Covenant and Covenant? I don't remember. I didn't hate Alien Covenant, but like, I wouldn't lose any sleep if the prequels were rendered non-canon. So, that's my stance. So if they want to say that drives are jump-based and that contradicts anything in the prequels, well, have at it. This is better. This is the better prequel than any of the fucking prequel films.
Ricardo, in case you're hearing me, I've got the Amicidora's basic power system. He's back online.
Wait, is this not?
Hopefully some light. Still no sign of Marlo.
Hey, Ripley. Welcome to the Amicidora.
Marlo? Where are you, Marlo?
Thanks for switching the power back on. You saved me a job. I only needed it offline temporarily. I had some things to fix.
This is all backtracking. Yeah, probably we're going through this front area now. This is like engineering or whatever. Yeah, that leads forward. That leads to the dock. Are we saved and everything? I don't think there's any other doorways off of that. Just thinking about loot.
Maybe you want to join my crew. Plenty of free spots.
Ripley? Mulder's really crushed me. He said he'd give me all the data he had on the creature so I could take it to the company, but...
Taylor? Taylor! Marlo, what are you doing?
What no one else seems prepared to do. Come find me, Ripley. I got something for you.
Fuck, that's so much flamethrower fuel. I kind of want to restart, just to save the fuel. I was totally unprepared for a facehugger here. It's a bad fucking sign. I would assume you could shotgun the little bastards. Does that hurt? No. Yeah, we're gonna reload. I don't want to use flamethrower ammo here because we're so low. Right. So we essentially know where we gotta go. No threats. Till the facehugger. That was the medical shuttle. Yeah, this way. Yeah, we looted that room right away. I remember that. Haha, funny joke.
We may have broken our losing streak. We've barely been scraping a living the past couple of years, and the Amicidora is starting to look like a wreck we salvage.
That's the exit.
Then we found that flight recorder. It belongs to a ship, the Nostromo, Weyland-Yutani property. That means there'll be a reward. But then Marlo had an even better idea. Extrapolate the path of the flight recorder to try to find the wreck of the Nostromo. We got lucky. Found a distress signal, and now we're following it. This is it. I can feel it in my bones. He always said he'd do right by me.
I assume the code is fixed, but let's check. 4510.
We're outside Sevastopol. Marlo and Foster woke up first. She looked terrible. Meeks and me are about to take a shuttle to the station. But well, this has got to break quarantine procedures, right? It's Marlo's ship. She's Marlo's wife. Things got heated, and Meek's got a bloody nose. So, I don't know. Maybe the doctor can give me all clear and things can get to normal. But if they sniff it out when we get on board, I don't want to part. Marlo doesn't make nearly enough for that kind of noise.
Nice that it doesn't kill me. That would have kind of sucked, actually, to restart it a third time. Watch me fuck this up now. Nope, we got it. Could try and revolver the hugger, but that feels like that's doesn't leave much leeway for mistakes.
Ricardo, in case you're hearing me, I've got the Inesigoi's basic power systems back online. Doors should be open. Hopefully some light. Still no sign of Marlo.
Hey, Ripley. Welcome to the Anisadora.
Marlo? Where are you, Marlo?
Thanks for switching the power back on. You saved me a job. I only needed it offline temporarily. I had some things to fix. Maybe you want to join my crew. Plenty of free spots.
Taylor? Taylor! Marlo, what are you doing?
What no one else seems prepared to do. Come find me, Ripley. I got something for you.
Okay. Shotgun orc's good for pulping huggers. Literally, oh, dude, there's actual 3D effects there. That was cool. Hugger, like, melted into the floor, sorta. Sort of, kind of. Best the game could do with a simple little decal, but pretty good effect still. A radio. Another passcode. Security access tuner. Okay. Well, we'll check that. We got a thing. Which is not immediately useful to us. Noisemaker sensor, okay. What was attached to the Foster is dead. Found her by the floor by her bed, all curled up like a spider. Said she felt fine. Insist on putting her in hypersleep. Yeah, that was smart. That's smarter than they were with Kane. Thing must have done something to her.
Anisadora, this is Marshal Waits of Sevastopol. Officially, I should deny your request to dock. Sevastopol is currently being decommissioned, and I can't compromise security for unscheduled vessels. However, in the light of the property you found, I will allow a small number of your crew to dock via a short-range shuttle. I must remind you that Sevastopol is entitled to a cut of any reward for return of said property once it's on station. Let me know your decision. Waits up.
Well, that didn't pay off very well, did it, Waits? Wait. Okay, fuck it. Redo it. Let me in! You know what? It's probably a good place to use flashlight because, like, huggers. No reason for to be stealthy. Real question is, why are there fucking huggers on this ship?
Contact, it's one. The company is never gonna know what happened here.
Not a bad idea. He's not wrong. We're missing a blasting cap there. Seems to be a healthy amount of booze on board. Oh god, thank fuck for flamethrower fuel. We're just kind of back to where we started on that stuff. What about what we picked up? Oh, there's the same thing right here. Alright, I think maybe we should take a break here for now and continue on with the Indicadora next time. So let's do that.